When I came to Disorder's conclusion, there were two different viewpoints that expressed my thoughts for Swagbite and Screwattack Games' psychological platformer. One was the tears that shed from my eyes and the depressing conclusion to an incredible and original story. The other was disappointment, wishing I loved the gameplay just as much as the story. But unfortunately, Disorder suffers from a few issues that prevent it from being one of the best indie games that came out of SGC's Indie Heaven. Disorder is a story-driven psychological platformer that takes place in the thoughts of someone who suffers depression and schizophrenia. Story-wise, this brings the main character's past memories of his dead brother to tell a believable and powerful story of how and why one might be impacted going through depression. And in this main character's case, his treasured brother fatally disappearing. There's no specific character names in this story. What makes it work is that it's not trying to develop a cast of characters with equally jarring personalities. Instead, it answers the question of what could possibly happen to you if all hope was fading. That someone or something important to you is no longer there. I know that feeling because I've been there, and I'm sure a lot of you have. And it's supported by an incredible presentation, which takes a distinctive 8-bit art style to recreate the corrupted nature of schizophrenia, and the soundtrack that's as emotional and grim as the story. Now for the gameplay. You navigate through each of the levels using two dimensions, positive and negative, and you'll be cycling through those two dimensions often in order to succeed in getting through some devious challenges. There's not really a huge difference between these two dimensions other than one platform being revealed and the other one disappearing. The platforming is pretty good, up until part 3, where the last couple of levels felt like they were rushed for the sake of extending the game. I wasn't having nearly as much fun near the end as I was throughout most of the game, and that wouldn't be much of a problem if the game wasn't so brief. I completed the game in 4 hours, spending a lot of my time reading through the main character's diary, and some into finding the collectibles. If you're not interested in either of those things, you can complete the game in possibly 2 to 3 hours. And outside of reading the main character's diary and finding some collectibles, that's all you're really gonna get out of this game for me. There's no difficulty setting or leaderboards. While the platforming is fun, with a few nice tools such as elevators and crabs that turn into platforms, it loses its creativity near the end, as the levels didn't feel refreshing, and I didn't feel like I was taking on a new challenge either, minus the digital tide wave. And as much as I enjoyed the gameplay throughout most of the game, I personally didn't feel motivated to go back and playing it again. Disorder is an experience more than it is a game. The story and visuals are fantastic, but where the story keeps you engaged throughout the whole ride, the gameplay and level design doesn't. If a great story and visuals are what you seek in a video game, definitely buy Disorder, and your only regret is to how short the game is. Otherwise, I would add this to your wish list and wait for the price to go down. It's still a platformer worth your time. I unfortunately didn't love the final product as much as I loved the SGC demo, but Disorder is still a good game. This is Chase from Indie Games, signing off.